All right, ladies and gentlemen, so it is now time to play the second half of Resident Evil 2. Even though we beat Leon's campaign, technically that's not the whole game. There's a whole other side of it to play Claire's scenario from the B-run perspective, and that's what we're about to do. And we're going to go ahead and, yes, we are going to be doing hardcore mode, just like I did in the original game. So here we go.
Oh, shit. Here we go again.
So let's see how Claire comes into all this. Trying to find out if Chris is there, and we know he's not.
You know me, I'll be fine. I'll be back as soon as I find Chris.
Alright, so she shows up at the gas station. Oh my god!
Don't shoot!
She runs into Leon.
Come on!
They escape together, here we go. So this we've already seen.
You?
So they're thrown to other opposite sides of the car.
Go on ahead. I'll meet you at the station.
All right. So for those who don't know, you might want a clarification because of what the difference is between A run and B run. The A run is the first run you do in the game with one character. When you complete the game with that character, if you then play through the game with the other character, it's considered the B run. It changes the campaign. And there's different perspectives, different bosses you'll fight, or different versions of bosses than the A run. And there's the true ending unlocked if you do the B run. So that's why we're doing a B run with here with Claire. So, oh, whoa.
Leon, I'm sure you beat me here.
They started making graves next to the police station for the people who had been zombified and died. Oh, God. They're gonna twitch. She only has 3 bullets. That's it, 3 bullets. She has the snub handgun, SLS-60. 5-shot capacity, 9mm handgun. It's very easy to handle, it says. I wonder if that means it aims more quickly. Ah! Leon was here, remember? I walked up to this, I said, I remembered you could walk around the police station. So not Leon, but Claire can, because here we go. Aha! Well, we found our first door to unlock once we get the bolt cutters. The chopper crashed. So that actually happens way later on in Leon's story, right? So we're actually skipping a significant chunk of the story playing this with Claire from side B. Interesting. Quinn is asking, will I ever do a Claire A, Leon side B playthrough? Possibly. I'm definitely not going to be doing it soon. After playing through this game from both sides once, you know, that's going to be enough for me, unless I want to do, like, a Hulk playthrough. But I'm definitely not going to be doing it again right away. Look at this guy. Oh, I found the bolt cutters already. Wow, she gets them right away. Yeah, it's like 3 hours into the game when
Claire,
this happens to Leon.
Hold on, I'll be
at
right
least.
There.
Okay.
So what the fuck was she doing in Raccoon City all this time? We don't even know. Alright, so let's get to a safe area. And then I'm gonna see what... Oh god, here we go. Wow, I already got bit. Nothing I can do about it either, because I've only have 3 bullets. I can't kill any monsters. Yeah, I can't kill any zombies yet. I had to get bit. Okay. The quick draw army? So she has two different handguns. Alright, we already know about the health stuff. What's the quick draw army? A 6-shot capacity, 45 caliber, single action handgun. Various customizations exist, each with their own name. Okay. Okay. Now, someone had mentioned in the pause menu. Here we go, costumes. I unlocked alternate costumes. Let's take a look at. So, this is Claire's default costume. She wears the red jacket. See that? Look at these assholes walking outside. They can't get in because it's a save room. Once I go out there, it's going to be annoying. So, this is her default outfit. A red kind of pleather or leather jacket with a necklace. Let's see what her other outfit is. Okay. The alternative outfits, you know what these are? These kind of look like the outfits from the original game. They are. Yeah. So, now she's not wearing a jacket at all. It's almost like a dress. And she has a shoulder holster with a knife in it, even though she doesn't actually have a knife. So it shows that, whoa, made in heaven. That's the symbol that's on the leather jacket in the Star's office, right? Did the zombies go away? I think the zombies finally started walking away. Oh, Jesus H. Christ. Seriously? There's a red herb. Fuck, there's a red herb there. I'm gonna have to go back and get it. Oh my god, there's more! More spawn. I guess I can't get it now. There was ammo there that I didn't get. Are you serious? I don't think they can follow me in. Oh, for the love of God. Oh. There's a lot of fucking zombies, man. Are they gonna die? They're on fire and they're not dying. What the fuck? They don't die. How do they not die from being on fire? What the fuck? This makes no sense at all, so I can't go inside because the zombies block it. Haha. There's no way I could kill them. What really sucks is I'd like to get the red herb right now. Combine and heal to full health, but there's too many zombies out here. There's like a lot of zombies. Oh my god, there's two right here. And then the green herbs in the next area where there's two more. Or the red herb. Fuck, I can't get it. I got fucked. I can't get that herb until I have much more ammo. The door's open. Chris actually left the door open. Or Chris. Leon actually left the door open for me here. Scrap of paper. Way out. Doesn't really help with the puzzles. Another first aid spray. We can save the game. There's zombies upstairs. Mr. X!
Bet he's not part of the rescue squad.
There's no item box. And also no save point. Oh shit. It's definitely changed. That's kind of messed up, actually. So, I could go back into the office and try to clear it. Right? Or I could try to head to the other side. I don't know what to do here. Huh. Oh, come on, there's another one? Dude, there's a ton of zombies. There's a ton of fucking zombies. Ugh. It could very well be that the car was an... Oh my god, seriously? It could well be that the car was in an accident or something, you know? What the fuck? I had the knife equipped, they didn't let me use it. The game is not allowing me to use my knife. I don't know why. I don't understand, I have it.
What was that?
I'm losing ridiculous amounts of health. I think it's a liquor in here. Oh shit. Oh shit! I have no fucking health! Oh, it wants to lick ya! Gives a liquor that keeps on ticking. More Capcom nonsense. I didn't touch it, yet it somehow knew I was there and killed me. Fucking garbage. Fucking garbage. I just wanted to touch the door so I would know what kind of a door it was for later, because it doesn't mark it on your map until you touch it. What? What? Did you see what happened? Did you fucking see what happened? The game slowed down, I couldn't do anything, and I died. What the fuck was that? The game actually slowed itself down, and I couldn't do anything. All the way back to the main hall, I guess. Oh, fucking shit! Oh my god, are you serious? What the fuck was that? It scared the living shit out of me, dude. Ah. Oh my god! Oh. Just popped a fucking Lincoln Log in my pants, man. Oh. Fuck. Is the combination the same? Because wasn't it like 9... It was started with a 9, I think.
Jesus. Son of a bitch.
I have no ammo. I shot the zombie in the leg with all of my handgun ammo. It didn't go down at all. What the fuck? zombie went. Oh, God. Is that it? There's another one up there. Dude, there's a lot of fucking zombies. Why are there so many? Why are there so many fucking zombies in this game? Statue of the God holding up his soul. This is ridiculous, dude. There's so many fucking zombies. 100 zombies in every corner. This is where the star's office is. Look, I'm all fucked up. I have no health. Fuck, I needed the valve handle. I don't have it. Shit. I need it. I gotta go back. I'm curious, should I, what am I gonna need upstairs? Do I need the round handle? I don't remember that. And that's for the other side. This really stinks. Great. Is it just me or does she take way more damage than Chris? Right? She's on fine. She's on perfect full health in one bite. And she's on damage. She's on danger. It seems like there's no middle healing for her. Right? What the fuck? Seriously, there's no middle healing for her at all. Bubble Bullet Bill says you might as well reload and just take the valve with you. You're right, since I took damage, you're right. Okay. By the way, why does it say autosave? It said auto. There is no autosave on hardcore. I don't know why it said auto there. Four of them, damn. They're really loading on the flame rounds. Even though I don't have a grenade launcher. Alright, this is where the liquor first premiered and appeared in Leon's campaign. But I don't know if it's gonna be here or not. We'd already seen the liquor, so maybe not. Oh no! I gotta start again. I need the detonator. To put the battery in the detonator, I need the detonator. So I need to get that too. Alright. Fucking reload again. Oh! There's no way to know what you need until you're already there. Fuck. No! That shit is not fair. Now, how do I lose them to get back up there and use the C4? At least I can unload some items, I guess, but... What the fuck? There's too many zombies out there, too. Adrenaline Dragon, yes, this does seem way harder than Leon. It seems way harder than Leon. Because she can't take any damage. Every time she gets bit, she loses almost full health. She can only get bit twice that she's dead, so basically one hit is allowed, that's it. She's a wimp. That's it, I don't even have anything to equip to be like a defensive weapon. I have 10 flame rounds. 10. I have some machine gun ammo, but I haven't found any of these fucking weapons yet. What the hell? Let's see if those zombies are still out there. Looks like she got a bite mark on her neck. Bloody bite mark. The fuck was that noise? Try this again. Well, 10, 10, 10 did a $13 tip. It says zombies just want a little treat. This is ridiculously tough. My problem is I have no effective weapons at all. None. My guns are fucking worthless. They don't do any. Both guns. Both handguns are complete fucking shit. Complete shit. So without an effective weapon, I can't stop even a normal zombie and they all get to bite me. I don't even know what to do, honestly. I'm not sure what to do here. I'm seriously fucked. I don't even know what to do. These guns are terrible. They hold such little capacity and the bullets don't do anything to the zombies. One of them dashed said that if I, at the start of the game, when I had gone to the top floor with the flaming zombies, that up there, if I kept going, there was the weapons key card, which would allow me to get the fucking grenade launcher. That's nice. I can't go back. I can't go through all those zombies and go back. No way. I went through so many zombies to get to this save room. I just have to keep pressing on and hope not to die. You know, it really sucks, but that's just what I gotta do. There's no way I can get the grenade launcher. Adrenaline Dragon, to get the grenade launcher, I'd have to go all the way back through this bottom floor, through all those zombies that I skipped, to get back to the main floor where there's three more zombies, run up the stairs past them somehow, with no ammo, get to the door, go through there, into the yard room to get it, then get all the fucking way back. It's not gonna happen. If I had ammo to kill the zombies, I could do it. I have no ammo. And by the way, these guns don't do anything. These guns are completely ineffective. They don't do shit. They don't do shit. If the guns were effective, then this would be fine. But the guns don't do anything on hardcore mode. They're just worthless. They don't deal any fucking damage. They don't kill any zombies. This sucks. Yeah. can't get out. No, I can't. Where the fuck is the door out here? Here it is. Alright, so I have to run upstairs past all those zombies to get into... What the fuck? I don't have the second floor map. The second floor has the room that gets you to the art room. The waiting room, right? Oh, I need the spade key. Well, now I'm really fucked. I thought you could just walk through there. I'm really fucked.
Son of a bitch.
So I guess I gotta go upstairs and try to get this fucking grenade launcher, right? From behind. Because without the grenade launcher, I don't know how I'm gonna survive on the other side of the fucking thing. I just don't know. I don't see how I can. Right? Because over there is where the key card is what everyone's telling me. Alright, I guess we're gonna go for it. See how this goes. With my fucking 4 bullets. I know exactly where the art room is, Adrenaline Dragon. It's outside this door over here. You gotta go up the fire escape past the zombies that are on fire. Yeah, it's up here. It's in here. Past these zombies. I fired twice, he still grabbed me. He still grabbed me. So I gotta go back across the other floor again, past this liquor, past the zombies, and I need to get to the weapons locker room. Remember, this is the room that has the lockers in it. And then I gotta open that fucking locker, and I guess that's how I get the grenade launcher. I guess. Now I have to survive. With one bullet. A single fucking bullet. You gotta be kidding me. There's another zombie in here. God. Well, you know what? At least I got it now. Fuck me. Here's the thing. I am gonna say, but we know that once I get past the Star's office, that's when it triggers Mr. X. Right? So maybe if I only enter the Star's office and don't walk past that point in the hallway, maybe it will never trigger Mr. X. And then I'll be able to go to the third floor and do the battery or do the bomb puzzle and he won't chase me? Maybe? Because wasn't it the hallway near the Star's office? That's where Mr. X triggered, I think? This game is a mindfuck, too, because you gotta, like, plan out an extensive strategy of what you're gonna do. As soon as you leave the Star's office, he comes after you, says ProxGamer21. Well, that sucks. Because you have to go to the Star's office to get the battery so that you can go arm the explosive, right? So that really sucks. Relizin says go to the library first. I don't even know how I'd do that. How would I do that? You can't go to the library first. Isn't it locked from the main hallway? And you unlock it from going in the back way. You basically have to get past Mr. X. Mr. X is blocking the hallway to the library. So you have to juke Mr. X, go to the library the other way. Oh, you can go to the third floor first. Ah. Okay, that could be an idea. Go to the third floor first. Get into the library that way. See what's in the library. Then come back here. Sadly, though, when you come back here, there's more zombies, right? Let's see. Alright. This is going to be a dead run, meaning I'm probably going to die and I don't care. What I'm going to do is explore. I'm going to try to go to the third floor and see what's up there. Kay says, can you explain why Mr. X is wearing a trench coat? Because I guess he was supposed to be undercover or whatever. I don't think that he was supposed to be... He's different from everyone else. Everyone else got infected by the G virus. He's infected by the T virus. So he's got a completely different story. Like, I don't think he's even supposed to be involved in any of this. But I think someone, like, releases him into the city or something. Hank Hill Propane got his resub for 12 months, 1 year. As a sub, Hank Hill, thank you very much for that, man. Go get the spade key on the third floor. Right, that's what I think I'm going to do. I'm going to try to get the spade key. Oh, look. It's not blocking anymore. So I can get into the library now. Oh, I see. Adrenaline Dragon says if you detonate the bomb, that's when the bookcase falls over and blocks that door. That makes sense. Is Mr. X or Nemesis the more formidable foe, says Himanoma? I would say Mr. X. Nemesis is just a copy of Mr. X. Mr. X is the original and the cheapest. Film I don't need. I have an extra item and I can't fucking store what I need. Shit. I don't need this. Right? Oh, are all the rules of film identical? If they are, I'm just gonna toss it. I don't need any more of these fucking pictures. It's the key for the lion statue. I need it. I can't drop anything then. Which sucks. I need to drop something. I guess the gunpowder is the only thing I can drop if I'm going to get the book. Unicorn is two guys holding hands and the scales, and I don't know what the third one is. Just guess. Two best bros forever. Scales of justice and that stupid thing. Oh, there we go. Fuck. I need to get the book. I have to get the book, so I have to drop something. If I drop the film, then I need to get the solution for someone else. If I drop this, then it's less ammo for later. Fuck the film? Yeah, you guys can just tell me the combination. I'm Butter Sauce, she said the most crazy thing. Go open the spade door, go place this middle of the statue, come back and get it. Come back and get the book. Oh my god. There's two fucking zombies down there. And not one... but two, one on each fucking way down the stairs. The third zombie's gone because I killed it in the room. The only thing I could think of that would make this worth it, lure both zombies together and shoot them with one grenade. That's the only thing I could think of that would make this worth it. Seriously. The line code is Crown Fire Birds as Leon Kennedy. Fuck this. Fuck this. Hemanoma Trader said Leon has rock star hair. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Resident Evil 2. I'm continuing on from where we left off yesterday. And I have a plan of what I want to do. I'm thinking, okay, that what I need to do is I need to try to use up the spade key and open all the doors, and I think, if I remember correctly, if I do this well, I can actually get solve another puzzle. Because if I open the door to the library from the main hallway, I can grab the book right off the shelf. Right, it's right there. It's like it's right, literally right there. Then I can turn around and hightail it upstairs across to the waiting room, which opens the door to the art room, and that's the end of the spade key use. Then I can go into the art room, use the book to solve the art room puzzle there. By putting the book into the arm, putting it on the statue, you get the scepter, you push the button, you get the gem. I already have the box to use the gem in, right? And I don't know what's in the box. Wait, I don't have the box? I don't have the box. What the fuck? I thought I did have the box. I guess I don't have the box yet. All right, well anyway, I could get the gem so that way when I head across the hallway to go upstairs again, to the left-hand side, the western upstairs, to grab the box out of the locker room, I'll have the gem, so I'll be able to open it right away. So I think I want to do all that first. I want to get all that stuff done first before I work on all the other shit. Okay? So, do I want to hold on to this is the question. Right now, I have no healing items. I have to grab a healing item. I need at least one. Outside of that, there's not really much else I can do. So, I guess this is what I'm going to stick with. Okay. Alright, I'm going to give it a go and see how this goes. Why can't we be friends? Hold on a second. Why can't we be friends? Just choose. It says Kingdom Hearts 3 releases tomorrow. What do you think Square Enix should work on releasing next? The Final Fantasy remake? I don't know. They do so much stuff. You know, Square Enix publishes a lot of stuff. A lot of people don't realize that they do, you know, everything. Like Tomb Raider, and all kinds of shit. I don't know what they should do next. They should remake Chrono Trigger with modern graphics. Okay. So I want to try to get to the library door and open it to get the book. But the good news is they were right there. They were not in the way. This is the wrong door, but that's okay. I wanted to open it. That's fine. I got the shortcut open. Now I want to go up to the library and grab the book. There it is. Now I can go across, open up the door over here, and solve the art room puzzle. I already shot the zombie over here. It should be inside of the waiting room. I don't know if it's going to be alive, though. Oh, God! What the fuck? That's fucking stupid, but whatever. Not much I can do about it now. The zombie's at the fucking door. That's all the use of the key. Discard it. Alright, got the red jewel. What the fuck? I can't do this without getting killed. This fucking sucks. This sucks. It does. I can't kill any monsters. So I know what I need to do, but I can't do it without taking any damage. Because my gun is completely fucking worthless. The gun does not hurt the zombies. You shoot the leg, it doesn't do anything. You shoot the face, it doesn't do anything. She has two handguns that literally don't do anything to zombies. So you might as well just give her nothing. So I gotta try to do what I just did, but basically avoid zombies and not take any damage. It's gonna be like impossible. It's so fucking hard because the gun does nothing. The gun does nothing to zombies. What? Okay. Nope. I'm not putting up with your fucking stupid bullshit. Last time I was able to walk by him easily, this time he grabs me. Go fuck yourself. Go fuck yourself, RNG. Nope, I'm not taking extra damage because the game just decides this time to do a magic animation that grabs me. Go fuck yourself. Oh my god. So I'll be honest, I said this on pre-stream. At this point, playing the game on hardcore is actually getting to me. Like, it's not really that much fun anymore. Like, it was fun playing with Leon, although there were frustrating parts. At this point, this is becoming so gruelingly annoying, where the gun just doesn't do anything, that I really am not really having too much fun playing this. And I actually had a poll up on Twitter last night, what do people want to see me do? And I suggested, let's do some variety. Let's maybe do some Minecraft today, paired with Resident Evil. And everyone just voted Resident Evil all day again. And I'm like, well, this is the last time I'm doing it. Seriously. This is definitely the last time I'm fucking doing this all day, because it's just not fun. It gets to the point, it's so fucking annoying.
You'll cry. You're gonna cry. You always cry. See? You're crying.
Why did I choose hardcore mode? Because that's what everyone wanted to see. I thought, oh, we'll do some Minecraft today, or we'll do maybe some Black Ops 4 multiplayer. We'll do something different. People are like, no, we want more Resident Evil. I was like, all right, I guess I'll do it, but I don't know how much we're going to enjoy it. And right now, I'm not really enjoying it. It's bullshit. Fucking zombies. You can't hit me through doors and shit. Come on. Right now, the zombie's in the door. Mr. X doesn't show up till you go into the Star's office, Dooley. That's when he triggers.
What the hell?
It didn't fucking kill him! The flame round doesn't kill a normal zombie. Tell me he died. He better be fucking dead and not come back to life, dude. Alright. Bionichu, stop. I'm gonna say it right now. He said, don't waste ammo, you need... Bionichu, how the fuck do I get past a zombie that I can't hit? Just use your brain for a second. The bullets don't do anything. It's incredibly rare to get a head pop. I have two bullets in my gun. So either I just stand there and get eaten, or I hit him with a flame round. So please stop. Oh, he's wasting ammo! He's wasting it! Shut the fuck up. I'm serious. Just shut up. Like, it just pisses me off. People doing stupid shit like that. It's hardcore mode. Yes, I know I have to manage my ammo. It's the only way I can get through this hallway. Relax. Calm the fuck down. Stop telling me how to play. And let me play my game. Alright. Holy shit. Why am I toxic? What? I swear to God. There's another fucking zombie. He was not here before. That zombie was not here before. At all. It spawned another zombie.
Oh, shit.
Had to do it. I have no ammo. Nothing I can do. You gotta kill him. You gotta proceed on. Alright. I'm not mad. People are like, why are you so mad? See, I'm not mad. It's just, I'm tired of people, like, backseat quarterbacking the fucking game. Like, you can't do that. It's the badge. So this is how you get the stuff from the Star's office. But yeah, the bottom line is, you gotta understand. Alright. I'm playing the game. It's very hard. It's stressful. It's tense. I played all through Leon. It was a pain in the ass. I realized, yes, ammo management is very important. In this playthrough, as you can see, the handgun literally doesn't do anything. It does nothing. Okay? It's incredibly rare to even kill a zombie with the handguns. So, I've been micromanaging my inventory till now. I have to start using flame rounds or I'm not going to get past anything. I'll be here all day. So, please, just be respectful in the stream and stop trying to tell me what to fucking do. Oh my god, he used a flame round there. I did it all wrong. Shut up. Seriously, just a bunch of shut up. Toxic again. What's gonna be my game plan to get rid of Mr. X? I guess what I should do when he starts chasing me, run all the way back. I've killed the zombies here now. So the zombies can't fuck me. So I could run back to this hallway, run through this here, go upstairs to the room with the attic with the locked the door with the C4, lose him in that room. Run back downstairs, I guess, until I could totally lose him. Like, just lose him in that room, run back down here, and just wait until I completely lose him. I don't know how I'm going to completely lose him, though. I need to completely lose him so I could go upstairs and set the C4 and get the final medal. And that's what I'm wondering. How am I going to do that? How do I keep him off my ass long enough to actually use the C4? That's going to be the most challenging part of this whole thing. Alright, so before I go in the Star's office, I'm gonna go and open the door the long way to open up the shortcut back to the library.
Jesus, stay
there. Oh my god, he's already here. I'm already fucked. I thought he doesn't trigger from the Star's office. Wow, he doesn't trigger from the Star's office. He triggers from the hallway. I didn't know that. Now I'm fucked. Now imagine if I didn't kill these zombies. I wonder if he comes, does he come into the Star's office at all? I don't know. Maybe I can get to the Star's office and he won't follow me. I don't know if he follows you in here or not. Here we go. Big Old Goose asks, what is my favorite Resident Evil thus far? That's a tough call. 1 and 2 are good, the classics. I also like 7 a lot. 6 I thought was an outstanding action game, but that's exactly what it was. An action game. It wasn't really Resident Evil, you know? Leon's memo. Claire, I hope you get this. This place is crawling with monsters and your brother's not here. Just get out of here as soon as you can. I really hope you're safe. Letter to Stars members. Oh, this is Chris saying that he's on vacation.
This does not sound like Chris.
So maybe it's not Chris? Maybe that's supposed to be the catch, is that it's not really Chris. Alright, so I have a lot of ammo for this, but it's in the fucking item box. So I can't really even use this SMG right now. Alright, what else do we got in this office? Adrenaline Dragon says, time to save. I can't. There's no way. I can't get to a save box. There's no save point anywhere near me. And by the way, I need this again. Remember, I need this for later. So I have to pick this back up. Now I only have a spot for one more item. Sounds like he went to the other side of the mansion. Because he kept walking here and couldn't find me. It's weird there's certain rooms he can't go in, right? He can't go in the stars room. He can't go in any safe room. But he could follow you in, like, every other room. He's upstairs. It didn't spawn the zombies. I have no idea why it didn't. It almost always spawned three zombies right there, and it didn't do it this time. Your guess is as good as mine, but I got to the save room. I have no idea why it didn't spawn the zombies. That doesn't make any sense to me. Alright, well, let's store a bunch of stuff. It's definitely storing the acid rounds. Best compilation of visuals says, isn't it better for AI to be random than predictable? No, not in a video game. If you were trying to make a life simulator, sure. If you're trying to make an enjoyable video game, fuck no. He's in here. This is bullshit. I need to set the bomb. He won't leave the room. I need to put the bomb in. Coming. Alright, what's the solution for this? Well, there's a zombie. You heard him? Here he comes. Oh god. Well, I'm fucked. Oh no, I'm not. Oh my god, that helped. That fucking helped. Are you kidding me? No fucking way, dude. The fucking collapsible thing helped me. Oh my god. It helped. I can't believe it. Ink ribbons. A suppressor for the MQ-11. All right. Cool. Now it's fucking huge. Great. Just what I wanted. Take out another inventory space. Thanks. So I guess we're going to be heading into the underground area. Not the sewers yet, but the underground garage with the dogs and shit. Oh boy.
This is the way?
This is how my mom took me last time.
Sherry?
Oh shit.
I've been looking everywhere for you, Sherry. Brave little girl to leave your house in the middle of this mess. On the ground, hands behind your head.
Who the fuck is this?
Are you serious?
On the ground, now.
Who is this guy? Oh. Is that a different door? It is. This is a different area. Leon is never able to go over here, no.
Must be where that guy came from.
Ah. Well, you need... the diamond key to get into the elevator controls room. Express elevator to the chief's office and not for general use. So this is the chief of police. That was the chief of police, apparently. That's this way. Through the kennel. Which, again, the first time through is probably safe. Second time through, not so much. Oh, boy. So we got a liquor here already. That's interesting. All right. Let me get Baby Man Gaming up on the leaderboard. The liquor is eating the dogs. Oh, shit. Ew. That's pretty gross. Hopefully the stage is distracted. It sensed me, but I'm walking so slow that I don't think I attracted it. So no dogs. The liquors ate all the dogs. That's actually good. I hate the dogs. That was noisy as shit. Noisy ass liquors. So here you need, don't you need the crank to open this door, which we don't have, right? Yeah, we need to get the crank to open the door to the generator room, but we don't have it. Ah, I see. Bookish Awkward says, save some flame rounds for the plant monsters at the end of the game because Claire does not get a flamethrower like Chris. That's actually a really important tip. Thank you. Thank God the flame rounds are actually pretty abundant so far in the game. So, Baby Man Gaming just gave me $11 to become the top tipper for the day. Thank you, Baby Man. Let's get you up on the leaderboard here. You gotta be kidding. Well, what the hell? There's supposed to be an item in here I need. But I didn't get it. I'm really confused. There's supposed to be a key item in here. And I didn't get it. So what am I supposed to do now? Oh, there it is. Okay, it's the diamond key. Of course, now the other zombie wakes up. I just gotta juke him somehow. Great! Well, that was a great juke. Well, it's okay. I got a bunch of healing items. It's actually fine. I have a bunch of healing items. How do I get past him? He's in the way. Uh-oh. Bingo Goose Juice said, I believe in you. I don't know what to do. He's 100% in the way. I don't know if I can get past him. This sucks. He's not moving either. That's a big fucking tongue. To walk away. Okay. Nice. The JMB HP3. What kind of ammo does it use? Uses 9mm handgun bullets, so I don't need that little shitty gun anymore. First used double stack magazines. It was a marvel of firepower at the time. Due to how many rounds it could hold. 13 bullets in one clip. And the good news is, I think it has a laser sight, which is fucking awesome. And I have an attachment for it already. What is the longevity of my current career? I have no idea. But the bottom line is, it's the only thing that I could do right now to pay enough to make enough money to at least try to pay my bills. So I gotta stick with it as long as I can. And then you go from there, man. That's how life works. I love the people who have the flexibility and the freedom to try to plan out their futures. I've never had that in my entire life. And I probably never will. What is that? A dirty sock? Shoulder stock for the GM 79? What is the GM 79? Oh. I guess it made it better? I don't know what it improved by adding that shoulder stock at all. Where are we? A totally new area, a back area into the chief's office. And this is going to get us into the other parts of the station we haven't been yet. This is cool. So here's an item box. There's a typewriter, but I don't have any ink ribbons. Siberian tiger. I nearly came when I sliced its yellow belly open and its warm guts spilled out. I still smell a wild beast. This is the life. Pig. The specimen's body is soft, sweet, and white all over. It's mine forever. What the fuck? This guy's a sick fuckhead. Okay, so she's got the red keys, right? While Leon had the green keys, the spade and the club, which is funny because they're actually black in a deck of cards. So I'll be saving, then using the heart key to explore the mansion. All right, back into the station. If I remember correctly, there's at least one to two more locks that use the heart lock. One of them is downstairs. I think it's one of these doors is a heart lock. Right here. I think it's this one. To get into the records room. I'm almost positive. Because the other one I think is a club key. And only Leon gets the club key. So she has to eventually go back there and see what's in the records room. Let me out. Oh god. Isn't this weird? Something. Is it a liquor? Fucking jumps through here or some shit? I think so. Fuck. I think a liquor jumps through here. Whoa, two more ink ribbons. First portable safe we found. At least with her. This sucks, so I need to get past this zombie now and waste ammo. If I had known, I would have grabbed the board from the item box and put it there. In fact, you know what? Fuck it. Now that I know that, I'm going to grab the one board I have in the item box, come here and immediately do the window so I don't have to fight that zombie. So the liquor bursts through, you can run out and run back in, and then you got to jump over, I believe. So. There's a blue herb that I can't carry. If you remember when I went down there the first time, I put out the fire, I did a ton of shit down there, but then Mr. X came after me. There's also a save room down there, but I don't know if there will be for Claire. Maybe it won't be a save room. So once again, I gotta backtrack to the item room and dump off shit again. Mr. X. The ladder did not break this time. Mr. X can't climb ladders, can he? Yeah, Mr. X cannot climb a ladder. Okay. He can climb the ladders? Oh, fucking shit. Well. I'm glad I came back here then. Holy shit, I didn't know that. Okay. Dude, he's right outside. But he can't come in here. It's a safe room. Slamming doors and shit. But Aris just cheered. He said, what was your worst streaming experience? When were you thought to yourself, God, I wish I was somewhere else right now? Honestly? I don't really ever have that reaction. 3 years ago, almost 3 years ago, I had my accident on stream. And quite frankly, even after that, I just didn't care. I just kept playing. I played Neo all day. I did like a 4-hour stream of Neo after that and didn't give a shit. I don't give a shit about stupid shit. I just don't, you know? It just doesn't bother me. I just like, whatever. I just go with the flow no matter what happens. What is it with the inventory in this game, man? I gotta keep coming back. Oh, look, I gotta come back here again to get the knife and get this part. I do. This sucks. I should have left the blue herb is what I should have done. Swanger says drop the blue herb. I could have just done that. So I gotta get back to the save room and unload again.
What the fuck is this? Surprise, motherfucker!
I'm stuck. There we go. I don't think I took any damage. No, I didn't. I got tossed, but I didn't take any damage. That's good. So he helped me. He threw me out the door I wanted to go out. The fuck, he's right there. How am I supposed to get by him? This is so annoying. He won't move at all. He's walking back and forth in a circle like da. How do I get by him? I can't get past him. He won't leave the area. I don't know what to do. He will not leave. Oh my god, so annoying. There was no zombie in here before. The game spawned a zombie out of nowhere. I'm fucked. This is bullshit. The game spawned a zombie out of nowhere. How is this fair? You missed. Why is there a zombie? That's a new zombie that wasn't there before. Okay. What? What the fuck? Well, at least it's only caution. But that's fucking annoying. There's a licker! They added a licker! I'm fucked. I have no healing. They added a licker. I am so fucked. The only way I can survive is to get down to the bottom floor to the save room and heal myself. I made it. They didn't spawn any zombies. Oh fuck, I think he's right here. Let's just relax for a bit until he goes away. Oh, Swagger says the SLS can be upgraded to become a Magnum. It's OP. Oh, I didn't know that. I did not know that, of course. Let's wait for him to walk away. Hello, Gokhan Arif. He's above. He's going up and down the floors, but I can't tell if he actually comes down to this bottom floor or not. My one problem I'm gonna have is, you remember there were multiple zombies inside of the fucking storage room last time I was there? There was one on each side, if you remember. So it's going to be a major pain in the ass to get in there and open up all the doors and get all the stuff with the two zombies in the way. I could kill them because I have enough ammo, but then Mr. X might come after me. So this is going to be a tough decision here to figure out what to do. Ugh. Wait, why is there a zombie next to the liquor? What do I do here? I might have to get the flame rounds. There's absolutely no way I could get past the liquor and a zombie because the zombie's gonna see me and get alerted. Yeah. I'm gonna go back for now. I might have to get the flame grenade for this. It sucks, but the way that they've laid out the enemies, I don't really have a choice. Okay, the liquor's dead. Great! Yeah, you're right, Adrenaline Dragon, he respawned, because he was upstairs. He was upstairs, you could hear him walking upstairs when I was shooting them, then all of a sudden he appears in front of me. Complete nonsense. I thought Mr. X was upstairs. It's complete bullshit. I always love it when a game cheats, but you know, it's that modern game programming like I told you guys. Why is there another How can there be a zombie here? I just used flame rounds to kill two enemies, and a third zombie spawned on top of the same spot. There's no way. It's completely bullshit. Capcom sucks. Dear Capcom, you suck. Why are you spawning zombies in the middle of the fucking hallway? I'm tired of this, man. I want that ammo. Oh my god, he's so annoying. So I gotta lure him all the way back here so I can walk out to the door. And then I gotta get to the records room, which is through here and here. Alright, library puzzle piece obtained. I don't have the cloak key to get. There is none with Claire. I have no healing. I guess I didn't grab any. Great. What's this item? It's an ink ribbon. I need it. Oh my god, I need it. I could save because I just got more ink ribbons. Thank fucking god. It's not getting any easier, folks. So I gotta heal. The good news is I have full healing. And let's save the game. If I can manage to make it upstairs to the second floor and run through the shower room and through the star's office all the way down, unlock there, I can get to the back door of the library. Then I gotta get down to the ground level and do the library puzzle, which is gonna be impossible. Because there's three fucking zombies down there I didn't kill. So I may have to bring something like flame rounds or something to kill them because... Or craft some more 9mm handgun ammo. Because I gotta clear the room of zombies in order to do the fucking library puzzle and move all the bookcases, right? So not only do I have three zombies, we've also got Mr. X who's gonna be there. Like, this is a fucking nightmare. It really is. How I'm gonna pull this up, I have no fucking idea. Maybe I can lure this guy out here, and once he's lured out here, then I can just go in. And that'll be one gone. I don't know. The puzzle's on the other side. I need to get past these zombies to do it. I have to kill them or down them. I have to. And that's going to send Mr. X after me. Shout out to TTV Noble, who just resubbed for the 24th month in a row. 2 years, sir. You just earned yourself the Regal Crown chat badge. Give it a go here so people know what it looks like. Holy shit. He came straight for me, dude.
Let it go. X gon' give it to ya. He gon' give it to ya. X gon' give it to ya. He gon'
This is painful. Dooley just subscribed for the 26th month in a row. Thank you, Dooley. They're all at the bookcase now. I think they're dead. But now I gotta do this with X on my ass. Jumped and stomped the zombie. He stomped it. Did you see that? It, no weapon, just a knife. Time. This is it. I did it. I can do it now. Fuck him. Now I have absolutely no... Dude, I have no ammo and nothing. I don't have the gear to do the clock tower puzzle, but I can open the door if I can get past the zombie over here to go to the save room. Nothing I could do. There's nothing I could do about this. I had to get hit. Alright, I gotta get past two zombies. I have two grenades. Wow, that didn't work at all. That's what I really hate about this game. There's really no effective way to dodge a zombie. There absolutely were effective ways to dodge zombies in the old Resident Evil. There's none in this game. I'm assuming this is just her trying to solve a puzzle. And there's no actual danger, I hope. A picture block. I really wish I'd saved now. I seriously do, because I don't want to have to redo so much gameplay. That didn't work. How the fuck? This is impossible. Oh! All that for a pair of fucking child scissors? All that for a pair of child-proof scissors? Ah! Why not some Elmer's glue? Or Play-Doh? Looks like pieces from a symbol of some sort, but I can't really tell. Ugh. These stupid puzzles, they suck! This puzzle sucks! Fucking shit. This is gonna take like an hour to do. Ugh. It's all about moving the right piece first. I don't know which piece to move first. Wait, I think I figured it out. Here we go. This should work, I think. No, fuck. God damn it. Everything needs to be rotated once. Oh, there we go. Oh my God.
Wow. That was so hard. Promise, if you fucked it up, if you did the wrong move, your first move, you're completely fuck yourself. Alright, fuck that stupid shit.
Blank's diary. If you're reading this, go call police. Boogeyman here, eating everybody. Many bark boogeyman's here. Help, they're coming. Help me, mommy. Alright. Well, Swaggins was right. Props to Swaggins, he was absolutely correct. There were a lot of people in stream chat saying there weren't.
Help! Somebody, please!
You stupid bitch, that's a dead end!
Gotta hide.
I don't know where to hide. I just infinitely walk in circles here. Like Mr. X, maybe. Until he gives up. He's locking the door.
It's all over now! Door's locked! Where are you? Show yourself! I know you're in here! The longer it takes me to find you, the worse it's gonna be!
Alright, so that's a new path. He just opened a new path. I thought maybe this was the way out, but I don't see anything. I might be fucked now.
I see you.
Yeah.
Game
well,
over,
I didn't know. I thought that was a new path. I was like, oh, this is the way out. I go over there, it's a dead end. It was a trick. A dirty, rotten trick. A dirty, rotten trick. So I don't know where to go. I have no clue.
You are gonna be sure. Dead.
The game started me facing him after the cutscene. The game started me facing the guy chasing me after the cutscene. How nice. Totally fair. Oh my goodness. At least I saved. I guess I gotta go to the right when he opens it up, not to the left. To the left is the fridge, and to the right is where I need to go. Okay. By the way, this was all in the original Resident Evil 2.
Doors
yeah,
locked.
Right.
Where are you? Show yourself! I know you're in here! The longer it takes me to find you, the worse it's gonna be!
Alright.
Oh god, oh god.
Just gotta be here somewhere. God damn it! I see you.
No!
Sheriff.
I don't want to do this anymore. We all know how much I love stealth. I fucking seriously don't want to do this anymore. This has nothing to do with the rest of the game. It's a waste of fucking time. It's annoying as shit. I just want to fucking play the game. I don't want to waste my time with garbage that they wedge in to claim this new content. Whoa, what? How do I do that? How do I break that? I don't know. I have no weapons and she can't attack, so how the fuck would I get that? I have no idea. How the heck would I break the raccoon?
It's all over now! Door's locked! Where are you? Show yourself! I know you're in here!
Fucking boy.
The longer it takes me to find you, the worse it's gonna be!
Thank you, Mikey, for the cheer. However, I'm not going to read that joke you just said.
The bitch has got to be here somewhere. God damn it!
Dude, where do you go? There's nowhere to go. Look. The door doesn't open. I have no idea what to do. I'm about to fucking turn it off. I'm about to turn it off. It's just fucking stupid. It's a waste of my time. I'm just gonna look it up. I'm just gonna look it up online so I can just do it and get it over with, because it's a fucking waste of everyone's time. The door does in front of her doesn't open, and there's nowhere else to go. So fucking boring. Just let me play the real game. Like, the real game's not hard enough. Let's add in a really annoying piece of shit segment that has nothing to do with anything else. This sucks. The funniest part about it, this is the only real original part of the game. Everything else was redesigned from 1998. The one original part of the game that they made themselves sucks. It's really shitty.
It's all over now! Door's locked! Where are you? Show yourself! I know you're in here! The longer it takes me to find you, the worse it's gonna be! Chance. Show yourself. Now! Oh, fuck. It burns!
Uh, I'm stuck. I can't move.
Hurry.
So, should I save here or not? I don't know if there's going to be an opportunity to save after I open the garage or not. And that's what makes me nervous. I certainly don't want to have to redo that again. I'll wait. Okay. Oh my god. What a big doof. Miss me, bitch. Gun shop when you need it. Then.
Looks like the only way forward.
Back alley blues. In the original Resident Evil, you originally go to these back alleys first before you even get inside of any areas. So it's kind of interesting that now you're going to them. It's a dead end. Oh. Have a grenade, bitch!
That's gotta be the orphanage.
That's how it's done, motherfucker! That's how it's done! Haha! No damage, baby!
Hang on, Sherry.
King Gogus is one of the breakable raccoons was on the bus. Fuck that shit, then. Who cares? You think I was gonna go back there to get it? There was no way I was gonna know that unless I had already known that ahead of time. So that means there's no way to actually get all the breakable raccoons unless you know where they are, which is horseshit. You can't just look for them because they cheated and put one on the bus during the segment you needed the rerunning. So fuck you, Capcom! Alright, anyway, no damage run, completely flawless, and I got a ton of items, so good shit.
Sherry, come on.
Mr. X, open up for Mr. X, little wrinkle face, hello, I'd like a hug, oh. Her father is defending her. Oh, shit! Whoa. So now Mr. X is dead? That's completely different from Leon's plotline. It doesn't even make sense because Leon fights him. How did that make any sense?
Can you hear me?
Alright. There will be a second stream plus that, but what I'm saying is... What the fuck? Come on. Well, that was fucking annoying. I guess we'll save again. It totally sucks I lost first aid for no fucking reason. You know what? Fuck this. Fuck this. I'm doing it again. I'm doing it again, and this time I'm not gonna waste my first aid. I gotta pass that zombie. I'm gonna pass that fucking zombie is what I'm gonna do. And not get bit. Good shit. Good shit. And I got 4 spare ink ribbons. For the first time, I think playing hardcore, I actually feel safe because I can save whenever I need to. Good God. All right. I believe Hunk is just a very quick campaign. Someone just asked, am I going to play Hunk after Claire? Someone told me it's only like 20 minutes. So, I mean, why not? Especially if I finish Claire early the next time I play, I'm sure I would do it. So what do you think? Do you think those monsters are going to be down there? I don't know. They might be. I didn't see one in the tunnel on the way in, which is very weird. We got the sewer key already. That's good.
Okay. This place is creepy.
Oh, it's there. Alright. Well, you remember the thing that killed it easily with Leon was the flamethrower. I don't have the flamethrower, but I certainly have flame rounds for the grenade, so I guess we're gonna go get it. Alright. Let's go back and get the appropriate weapons for the job, not a handgun. A handgun ain't gonna cut it. I can do about that at all. Well, I'll heal myself afterward. See if there's any more. There it is. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Oh, it died. It died after only two. I thought it needed three. It died after only two. The spark shot? This gun fires wired metal prongs to your target, allowing you to fire with electricity as long as you have the weapon raised. I continue to stay focused on your target. If you let the gun send too much power, the wires will snap after one final surge. What the fuck? How does this work? Big TJ says, how much harder do you think this is? I'd say a lot of the difficulty the first time around is not knowing how enemies will react. For me, it's just RNG. Like, there's been a lot of random shit that I'll run through once, there's no zombies. All of a sudden, I run through again, there's like 10. And it's like not even predictable what the fuck's going on. Like, why do all those zombies appear out of nowhere? It's very weird in that regard. The way that that's been happening during this playthrough. So... yeah, you know, for me, I think once you know what you're doing, obviously, it's easier because you're not wandering around with, oh, am I even in the right place or whatever, right? And it makes it easier to plan out a run. Like, earlier, I was planning out, I'm going to go from this part of the police station to this part, I'm going to go to this door, grab this item, unlock this, do this, do that. Once you know where everything is, the first time around, you're so confused in your head, you don't know where to go or what to do, and you're saving because you don't know when to save and what's safe and stuff. So, yeah, you know. All right, the knight isn't where the case marking says. The rook is right next to the knight, but not facing the queen. The king isn't next to the queen, but facing the knight, right at the end. And the knight ain't where the case marking says. This is confusing. I'm pretty sure this zombie's gonna get up again. Told ya. Oh, come on, from behind! This sucks. No, that's right. Mr. X is dead, right? I forgot. In this playthrough, Birkin killed Mr. X. There's no more Mr. X. So unlike when you're playing with Leon and you come back to the mansion, it's a pain in the ass because Mr. X keeps following you. Mr. X is dead. He can't come after you. I totally forgot. So this is actually much more safe than Leon's return to the mansion. There's another roll of film? What the hell's on that roll of film? I don't know, but I got all the items in here before. Yeah, I did. So we're just going to go right back, and I'll develop the other roll of film and see what's on it. Alright, what's on this roll of film? What the fuck is this? What was the point of that? What the fuck? Capcom, you bastards! You wasted my time! Yes, I am aware that's Rebecca Chambers from the first game. I don't know why the fuck that was in the game, though. That was incredibly stupid. Okay. Imperium Negro also cheers said, apparently, in the original Resident Evil 2, if you press something on the desk 50 times, that picture would have popped up. Okay, then. Kay says, which campaign is hardest, Leon or Claire? I would say Leon is harder because you don't know what to do. Claire's easier when you know what to do, but some of the earlier parts were way tougher with the fact that the guns, you only had two handguns, and neither of them were hurting the zombies at all. You know? Fuck all that shit. Yeah, I did it. I did it. That is victory right there. Skip that fucker. Juked him. While he was busy spitting out little shits, I juked his ass. And now this is done. Yep. I knew it. Good. Very nice. So, I'm definitely gonna need a healing item. In the fight with Chris... With Leon... Really, the only thing that was effective at stunning Birkin was the Magnum. Remember, I was using the Magnum to shoot him in the eye a couple times while I was waiting for the thing to swing and hit him? Oh, man. So... I think I used everything that had red herb in it. I did. There's nothing left. So a few things I'll do. Let's combine a green herb with that to make a max herb. So that's a max heal right there, just like the first aid spray. Right. We don't need the blue at all. I'm not going to need that for the fight whatsoever. That's not going to help. I think two healing items should be more than enough for the fight. Keep in mind, when I go down, there's going to be more ammo. So I'll bring the Magnum and the six shooter. That's what I'll use against him to stun him. Yeah. Okay. Here he comes. There's Birkin. Asshole. Of course not. He's an asshole. I'm dead. Instant kill. Yep. I almost had him, but again, he did the instant kill move, and there's no way to get out of the way. It's fucking complete bullshit. He had the positioning. There was no way. If I went right, he still would have got me. So it's complete nonsense. They shouldn't give him an instant kill fucking move. So dumb. I had him. This is not hard at all. It's just garbage, gimmick nonsense, and RNG. If he had just stood there and not did the instant kill, I would have shot him 2-3 times with the Magnum, ran, he would have died. Sad fact is she takes way more damage than Leon, and she actually takes damage from the claw, significant damage, while Leon barely took any. Look at this nonsense. I'm running full speed, he's still fucking hitting me. Come on. This sucks, I used all my healing items. Lame. Thank you to Otesh MC for the sub. I appreciate that. This fight fucking sucks. It really, really genuinely does. The fight sucks. Anytime he grabs you, you're done. The fight is just complete trash. They should never have given him that grab. And if he didn't have that grab, the fight would be fair and fun and interesting. The grab makes the fight completely annoying. There's no way you can avoid the fucking grab if he's close. You have to see the animation for it and run to the right. It's the only way to avoid it. If he's near you, you're fucked.
Shit!
Okay. That missed. It made no sense. It shouldn't have missed at all. There's nowhere to go to dodge that. It's impossible. Should be it. Should find out though. I think that should be it though. No, he's still not dead. He's still not dead. That's it, we're both dead. We're both dead. He did it again. You cannot grab. I told you, not once have I ever dodged that attack. You cannot do it. There's no way to dodge the grab attack. Even if you run by him, he turns around and runs at you again. So whenever he does that grab attack, you have lost. There's nothing you can do. You will lose. You cannot survive. It's a complete gimmick boss. It's not challenging at all. It's just complete garbage based off of a group of bad game designers who don't know how to make a good boss fight. Which is a shame because the first boss fight, in my opinion, is good. And that last Birkin fight is actually pretty good once you know what to do. This one is just a pure gimmick fight. It's completely worthless. And it wastes your fucking time. Dead. He did the grab. You can't do anything about it. There's no way to dodge it. If he does the grab, you lose. Every time I've died, it's because the grab. Because the game sucks. They made a terrible fucking boss fight. There's nothing you can do. There's no way to avoid the grab. There's no way. Wagman, that is not correct. He says, oh, if you hit the button and then you walk in front, it triggers the grab. No, he grabs anyway. He's done it when I never hit the crane. He still tried to grab me. And that's when I use the grenade or the knife. It's just RNG. He will randomly grab. Nothing triggers it. It's just the game rolls a die and says, will he attack or will he grab? And if he grabs, you're fucked. It has nothing to do with triggering it by walking in front of the crane. He's done it before then when I was able to use the grenade or the knife to get out. So that's completely wrong. I could do there. Absolutely nothing you could do because she's too fucking slow. He's gonna get up in time.
I got a surprise for you.
That time, it shows it only hitting me, even though he's there. I was actually behind the control panel. I was actually behind the control panel, and it hits me. It's just stupid. The fight is garbage. The fight is complete trash made by idiots. It really is. All you had to do was test. All you had to do was test the fight. That's all you had to do. Test the fight and see if it's fun and see if it's fair. That's too hard for Capcom. They can't do that. Instead, just put it out. Just fucking put it out. It's great as it is. Put it out. Who cares if it's fun? RN fucking G garbage. He didn't even touch me. That's a guaranteed hit. Hit me again, didn't touch me. He is counting as a hit. That should hit. Finally. Stupid gimmick boss fight. Terrible. No, I don't hate every game. I just hate really garbage gimmick RNG parts of games that could have been designed much better if people had talent. That's what I hate. So you know, it's absolutely hilarious because you got some people who are trying to be like fucking fanboys of Capcom defending them and defending this fight, but then they have to bring up personal insults against me. Like Gomez, who just got permanently banned because he's a dumbass fuck, and he'll never be back on my streams. He's like, oh, you know, it's not fair that you say these things about the game, and then he's like, oh, they have to bring up something personal about me. Well, go fuck yourself then. Dumb shit. It immediately negates your point when you go low blow, moron. It just proves that you had no point to begin with. The fight is a piece of shit. RNG grab, bad hit detection with the fucking swinging crane. It's a garbage fight. The other two major boss fights of the game are much better. Just actually, three are all much better.
You're gonna be just fine.
Why am I toxic? What?
Do not exit until the final destination.
Records, it doesn't matter if you get out of the grab because you get killed by the crane. You must not have watched the entire boss fight. The ID wristband. All right, so now your outfit changed. Yeah. For this final part of the game, the labs, your outfit actually changed. More flame rounds. Good, because I used a shitload of them. I remember having like 12 to 2. Fuck. Because I need those to kill the fucking... I need those to kill the plant dudes. And... there's one... well, there's one in the hallway. There's one... no, there's three out in the walkway. And then when you come back, another one drops. So I'm not going to have enough flame rounds to kill them now. I'm going to have to down them and not kill them. I basically fucked up by using so many flame rounds. Damn it, that sucks. Unless I find more here, which I might. But right now, it's not looking too good. No, BBMan Gaming, I'm not going to do a speed run of this game. No, I'm not. I don't have enough ammo to kill this guy. 5 shots probably won't be enough. Maybe it'll down him, though? Because I can't climb back up. No, I gotta go past him.
Oh, not good.
Oh, head pop! I got a lucky head pop on the final shot. Special Forces recording. Oh, I got the modulator already? I could go do this now, then. I didn't know I was going to get the modulator this soon.
So, antiviral agents in the West area.
Even more inventory space. So, actually, she gets more than Leon, because Leon can't get this much, I don't think, right? I could be wrong.
WRONG!
Alright, let's save up. And the next time I play for it'll be the final run, the conclusion of Claire. We'll see the true final boss, true final ending. And then maybe I'll check out the optional modes like Hunk and stuff like that. Cool.
The plan! One last time! We get some money and get the hell out of there. That's the plan.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the conclusion of Resident Evil 2. My intention here is to finish up the Claire campaign. If I have extra time, check out other content that will unlock, but... this is going to be it, the big finale for us, okay? Alright, we're going to kill this guy with a flame round. Nice! He didn't die, did he? I don't think he died. Maybe he did? I'm gonna go put this ammo away, but I'm not sure he died from the flame round. He might get up. He might fucking get up. I'm gonna test this. Put this away and walk back, see if he gets up. Damn, now we've got a ridiculous amount of fucking high-grade gunpowder. Look, so I'm gonna be... not only do I have 450 some machine gun ammo, I've been up for 3 more crafting, and I think each one's like 50. So basically, I'm gonna have like... oh, like around 600 some machine gun ammo for the final bosses. I think I'm going to be all right. I think I'll be okay. All right, let's see if he's dead or not, or if he gets back up. I hope he's dead. Nope. He's respawning.
You bastard.
Yeah, forget it. So, now we know the flame round is not down. What you need to do is shoot... the weak points. And once the weak points are shot, then hit him with the flame round to kill him, I guess. Alright, so I didn't know that. And that really sucks because I don't have any regular handgun bullets. So I can't shoot the weak points to down him because I don't have the bullets to do it. This stinks. How... the only thing I could do is, like, waste... I think I have, like, 2 regular gunpowders. So I could waste, like, those to make 8mm ammo. Yeah, so I can make 8mm ammo once to shoot the weak spots and down the guy. And then shoot him with the flame round to kill him. And that's it. Like, once I'm out of that 8mm ammo, I can't kill the fucking plant dudes anymore. Oh, man. I might just have to dodge them. I don't know what else to do. Because I don't want to waste the Magnum ammo on a little weak point. That's a waste of time. Actually, I don't know what Spark Shot is effective against. So when Swaggins was here the other night, he told me that the Spark Shot's good against the final boss. But I don't know what the final boss is. So I kind of want to keep it. I have no ammo for either of these guns. Yes, I am aware, Swaggins. Once you get past him, you only have to come back one more time. I know that, but it's annoying because... It's annoying because I want to be able to unload my items, and I know there's a lot of items down in the lab. You know? So, I want to be able to have those on me. I need the Magnum and the ammo because I got to kill those zombies in the hallway coming up. As long as it is the same zombies, I don't know. I think I'm just going to have to make some fucking ammo. Come on. Look how much you fucking move. Oh, fuck this. Fuck this. An instant kill, too. I 100% held it was an instant kill. Dude, it's so dumb. I can't even shoot the weak points because he goes, as he walks towards you. I can't even shoot the little things I need to shoot. This is fucking stupid. Ugh. I don't know what to do. Like, the knife doesn't down him. The only way I think I could down him, I maybe either spark shot, or I'd have to use some of the actual submachine gun ammo. I don't know how else to down this fucker, you know? Being honest, I don't know what else to do. Submachine gun to hit the weak points and then hit him with this to kill him. Dude, that really kills it. Yes. Okay, good. That will kill them. That's good to know that will now kill them. Good shit. Swaggin cheered, said, do you want me to tell you the two lab codes to save time? I have them written down from the first playthrough, so as long as they're the same, this should save time. I already know them. No. The codes were changed. Let me try the other one. Yep, they changed the codes. Alright, well, guess what? I guess we're just going to, we're just going to have to go in there, see the codes, write them down. I need a pen. Write them down. Or I guess I could take a picture with my phone, too. Because some people were recommending I do that. Just take a picture with my phone. Alright, there it is. Blurry as fuck, but I can take a picture. Alright, got it. That's one. I won't know the other one until I actually open this hatch and go under there and check it out. This is all just me fucking around. I'm gonna reload and do it again. So don't worry, I'm gonna do it again once I have the codes. So I can do it all in one trip. In the Leon playthrough, the code's on that table. It's not here now, so how the fuck do I get the code? I don't know how to get the code. So it could either be here, this server room over here, or it could be in that room over there, the cold room. Let's check the server room first. Where that high... Yeah, the stuff to combine. See, I'm not picking anything up because I'm going to reload. More flame rounds. Wow, this is good. I'm going to have extra flame rounds to kill these fucks. Okay. So now I could do most of it in one run. What I'll do is I'll kill... There's three of those fucking plant dudes out there. So I'll try to kill them all. And I'll kill the guy in the hallway. try to go to the room with the plant dudes, kill them, do the item mixer. I can do a lot in one run. Yeah. Okay. I got the two codes now. All right. So we got to reload. Swain says, don't kill the plant dudes outside. Once you use the chemical, they all die. Make sure you take the chem and fill it up before you go down the ladder. Yeah, but that's stupid. You have to get by them all twice. There's no way. I'm going to have to go past them all, get the chemical, get past them to the hatch, go down the hatch, go through the whole underground area, freeze, come back, go through all the plant dudes again, right? Oh, no, you know what? You're right. Can I go out the back way? I can go through the back way. There's a back door. You're absolutely right. If I go through the underground once, I can kill them all. You're right. Okay, Swangus is right. I just need to get to the hatch once, and I should be able to kill them all. Here we go again with this shit. Oh, boy.
Engaged. Adjust amount of solution to match cartridge capacity.
They changed the puzzle. Look, it's more liquid. Yes, I think I just figured it out. Yes. Okay. Doga Trader says, I guess you missed one in the police station. Nope. I looted absolutely everything in the police station. In every drawer, all of the storage lockers, everything. I think on hardcore mode, you only have a certain amount of inventory. Leon gets two less than Claire, and I think Claire only gets this many on hardcore. I'm almost positive, because I've gotten everything. I got literally looted every possible thing. There's nothing else left.
No!
Alright, so I need to walk out here, slowly, to the left through the door. Oh shit, that's the helix, I don't need it. And I'm fine. Then I think there's two zombies in that corridor to get to the shortcut door, and I'm good to go. I don't have to come back here. I just go this way, and I'm fine. The problem with Leon was I fucked up, and there were items over there I still needed. If you remember with Leon, I didn't turn on the power yet, and after I'd already triggered them, I had to come back down here, and that was annoying. I think there's one more upstairs, and then that's it. No more zombies. Oh no, what the fuck is this? That was not in the Leon side. This sucks because I can't kill him, but it's fine. I don't need to kill him. I'm pretty sure that dude was not on the Leon side, the plant dude.
The weed infestation.
I guess that killed them all.
You have dispersed a dangerous solution without authorization.
They get back up. Right away, too. That's good. zero damage. What? Where did he come from? He was not in here last time. They put a new enemy in the room that was not here when I played with Leon. Holy shit. Good thing I had the defense item, dude. That was brand new. God damn it. What the? I don't want that to happen. From behind. I don't know how to get him to turn around. And what sucks is I'm already almost out of first aid because she's a fucking pussy. This is the problem. She sucks. She's so weak. She can't run and she can't get behind it. If I knew where the first aid was, I'd be alright, but I don't remember where it is. I gotta find it. No, I'm fucked. I don't know where the first aid spray is. Oh, what's that? Got him! Nice! I had the tools for the job! I had the tools for the fucking job, baby. Now I can get all the shit. Hell yeah! Just Senpi, or Senpai, spelled it wrong though. She just said, how many bits would it take for me to get me to shave my goatee? None, because I'm not gonna do it. So there.
Hold on. Sure, what are you?
I think I can open it from the other side.
Oh my god, seriously?
God damn it, your timing sucks.
Oh my god! The fucking minigun? Do I really want this? Oh my god! I guess I'll do it. Here. Do I want the minigun? I don't know how much ammo it has. Haha! Get rid of the fucking knife. I'll get rid of the items here. I'll get rid of this and this. Yeah. The fuck? Where's the thing for this? Oh, come on! No! I need need to find some item to do this, and I don't have inventory space for it now. Where the fuck is the thing for this? Oh wait, here we go. I can put stuff away. Alright, where's the item that I need for this? I don't know where it is. You need the battery or something, I don't have it. Nope, I can't. That's it, item box is gone. So I'm stuck with what I got. I'm stuck with what I got. I wanted the item, so we're gonna give me more defense. Pretty fucked. I don't have any of the defense up items, so I'm fucked. 6 minutes until. Yeah, I'm done. I can't do it. I need the healing items that give me more defense, and I don't have it. So I gotta do the whole fucking thing over. Cause I didn't know they weren't gonna let me go back to the item box again. By the way, you're fucked. You always have to have you have to be without two items. You're fucked. You can't carry you cannot have it. Wow. This sucks. Cause he does insane damage. I'm gonna have to have more healing than anything else. Forget the ammo, I need all healing. I basically took an insane amount of ammo that I don't need when I needed like 4 healing items. To the bottom level train platform. That's exactly what I did. I fucked up. I need way less ammo and way more healing. Sucks there's no way to save here and not have to do this again, but what can you do, I guess?
God damn it, your turn.
Do anything. The spark shot did absolutely nothing. Zero. Great. Sparkshot doesn't seem to do anything. Not doing anything. I don't know if I'm hurting him or not. This sucks. I have no idea if I'm hurting him. How can I even tell? What? He landed on the side on top of me. This sucks. I don't think this is doing anything. No, that's not what you said, Swaggins. You said actually exactly the opposite of what you just said. You don't even know how to say anything in chat. He says, oh, use it when he's stunned. No, you didn't. You said use it when it will stun him is exactly what you said. Go ahead and go look at the chat logs. You said the opposite thing. Why am I toxic? What? No healing. I'm fucked. Well, I lose because I listened to Swaggins and he fucking didn't know what the fuck he was talking about. Seriously, he told me to use it to stun him and then hit him after. Oh, I said to use it to when he's stunned. No, you didn't. You're absolutely wrong. Go read the shit you already say. Why am I toxic? What? You just say, yeah, you just, when he's coming at you, you shock him. That's what you just said. That's not exactly, that he literally just copied and pasted his own log. That's wrong. When he's coming at you, you shock him. That is not what I'm supposed to be doing. Oh my god. So I gotta do it all over again. Well, thank you, Baby Man Gaming, for a couple cheers here. What a fucking waste. I don't know why I listened. I should've just did whatever. Really. I don't know why I listened. Just do it for myself. I probably would've beat it already if I just done it for myself. No, Swaggins, he's so trying to fucking fix what he said, and it's still not correct. Listen to this. Ready? When he's coming at you, you shock him. Then he said a second message. And when he's stunned, as in shooting with it when he's stunned. That's not what you said. You said, when he's coming at you, you shock him. You said to use the shock thing when he's coming at you, not shoot him when he's stunned. You were posting the incorrect thing that you said, proving that you were wrong. You're proving that you said the wrong thing. You should give up right now. You're just making it worse. Oh my god. Oh my god, Swaggin, just stop. Stop. Yes, it was an error. You said to shock him when he was coming at me. That's not what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to stun him, then shock him. But you did not say that, and you're trying to defend yourself when in reality you said the wrong thing. Just admit it. Just admit it and move on. It's fine. I'll beat the fucking boss. Don't worry about it. Holy shit. No, but you're absolutely right. I should have just done it myself. People are absolutely right. I should have just done it myself. Because I fucking... If listening to other people is always going to be wrong. I should have just tried for myself over and over until I beat him. Instead of fucking... That way, at least I have no one to blame but me. Instead of reading what someone says in the stream chat incorrectly. And then doing the wrong thing. You're right. It's my fault.
I gotta get this train moving.
I take the blame. I should have done it. I should have done it myself. I'll take the blame.
Something.
Because Swaggins, it's not what you said. Okay, Swaggins, you just proved it. Swaggins, just said it. Read what you posted. When he's coming at you, you shock him. S-H-O-C-K. Which means use the shotgun to shock him. Not shoot him. You did not say shoot him when he's coming at you. You said shock him. You said the wrong word. That's what fucked me up. That's the problem here. So you shoot him with this, then you shock him. Actually, I'm probably shooting with this first, then I'll shoot him with the minigun, then I'll shock him. Okay. Oh boy, run. Run. Wow, he actually reached me. See that? He clipped off the top of the train. Wow, I couldn't move at all. I better run. I think I stunned him. I did. Yeah. I'm out of bullets. I'm still at caution. Got him. Good shit. Oh my god. All right. So if I just played normally, I would have beat him. It's my fault. Again, it's my fault. I should have just tried.
Claire! It's okay.
Head to the last car. And you can save. Thank God. Because, by the way, I don't think any of my weapons are going to be effective for this fight either. I might as well just get rid of this now. Here we go. Get ready. Hello! That is hideous.
You gotta stop meeting like this.
So what do I shoot? I don't see the weak point.
Hope you like bullets, because I got a hell of a lot more.
I don't know what to shoot. I guess I was supposed to fire.
How the hell are you still kicking?
Oh, because I wasn't firing. Well, I guess I should have fired a little earlier. Oh, yummy! That's a good animation. Chomp, chomp, chomp. I'm glad we saw that one. I'm actually glad we got to see that one. I was looking for a weak point. I didn't realize you had to shoot him to expose the weak point first. What's a better campaign, Leon or this? Cody Carl's asked. They're the same. I mean, there's only variable difference. Claire's is much shorter, but earlier on, it's much harder. Like, honestly, I don't think I would have been able to beat Claire's if I hadn't played Leon's first. Just being honest, I don't think I would have been able to. They give you this knife. The knife doesn't do anything. It's completely pointless. Okay. Oh my god, I got it at the last second. I got it at the last second. Oh, that is it? Yeah, I don't think that was how it ended in the original. In the original, you get a rocket launcher. You have to shoot it in the eye twice, I think, to kill it, if I remember correctly. It doesn't just die like that. Alright, so they changed the end. So thank you to Baby Bay Gaming and Bagel Goose for your cheers. Apologies, I could, you know, do a shout-out during that action-packed sequence. That's it. Hardcore complete. Oh, I flipped them off.
Hey, that was Live Another Day by the Gray.
Wow.
He was friendly.
Yes! The masterpiece complete. So thank you, Tubar King and Orcs or Dorks, who also just did 100-bit celebratory cheers. Thank you, everyone. And we skip that. Skip that shit. Rank of C, just like Leon. Way shorter, though. Leon was really long. So, here we go. A heroine emerges. Silver trophy. I wonder if I'll get a gold trophy for beating out Hardcore with her. Yup, Hardcore College student. Thank you, Cody Carls. Oh, and Broken Umbrella, another silver trophy. I guess that's probably for seeing the true ending, I bet. Cody Carls of the 50-bit cheers, I walk alone into the unknown. Alright. So, game mode, Leon's second story mode has unlocked. Claire's normal custom costume has been unlocked. Extra mode, the fourth survivor, that's the hunk mode, has been unlocked. Has a bunch of concept art models. And a new costume, Claire Classic Custom, also unlocked for the for that, so. New game mode unlocked, the extras menu. There it is, the fourth survivor. And basically what it is, it's a challenge run. You play as Hunk, and you're running through, I believe you're running through the city, trying to survive. It only takes 20 minutes to beat, but it's insanely hard. Like, you have limited ammo, and everything, like, is fucking insane. But, that is it for Claire Side B, and that concludes the official hardcore 100% run through Resident Evil 2's remake. I hope you guys liked it. Like I said, that last boss fight was way different than it was in the original game, so it surprised me, because I remember having to use the rocket launcher. But, it was pretty good, and, I hope that you guys enjoyed the playthrough. Thanks, everyone, for watching. Later. Will they ever make Resident Evil 3? Probably. The rumor is that Capcom is very interested in doing it. We're probably going to see Nemesis in the future sometime soon remade. So, all right.
Not yet, Snake. It's not over yet. Liquid.
It's time for another good idea, bad idea. Good idea.
I'm at point K-12. Get it on the track.
Yes, there's no given down here in Raver. Ah, my track is working. Ah, sir, sorry. I'm headed toward the front gate of RPD. Pick you up there. Oh!
Bad idea.
We'll give it a shot here, but I don't know how well this is going to go. So, September 1998, Umbrella's private special ops group USS assault the secret laboratory nest. Sure we shouldn't make a will? Soldiers of the unit all look to one man as they laugh. Doesn't matter how tough the mission is, we'll survive. Even if the unit gets wiped out, he always comes back. The USS Grim Reaper. Also known as Hunk.
This is Nighthawk. Come in, Alpha. Alpha, do you read?
Nighthawk, this is Hunk from Alpha Team.
Man, I thought you were all wiped out. I've been trying
I'm at point K-12.
So, what do you get? You get an assault rifle. You get a shotgun. You get two different handguns. One is a mag, and one is just a standard 9mm handgun. You get some shotgun shells, you get some mag ammo, you get flash grenade, you get a hand grenade, you get a knife, you do get some gunpowder to combine. So combine with gunpowder to make shotgun shells, or combine two of these to make mag ammo.
Need info for extraction.
Guess there's no keeping it. Found the Grim Reaper.
My extraction point.
Relax, Mr. Reaper. I'm headed toward the front gate of REmake. Pick you up there.
Got it.
Okay. He bit? Are you serious? It didn't do anything. Alright. So after a resto cheered, he says, they announced free DLC starting sometime next month with the perspective of random survivors. We'll be trying them. Yes, if they're free, I will. Baby Man Gaming is asking if I watch the piece of the DJ Chomp Club. Well, what the fuck you're talking about? Whoa, it's dogs? Let's see. I don't know where I'm supposed to go. This door is closed, I don't know what to do. It's open. Now what do we do once we're there? I don't know. Big Ogre's choice, is this a police station or a dog shelter? Oh, I pressed it. It didn't work. I'm assuming I don't go through the door, I gotta go up. Up to the mansion. No, I can't go this way. I don't know what to do then. I'm supposed to go this way. The desperate run, the desperate run. Oh my god. Oh, Fucking liquors. That's it, I got no more healing items. I'm done. I can either make mag ammo or shotgun shells. I don't know what to make. I haven't used the shotgun yet. Or the mag. Fuck. Hopefully this is the right way. Saving it here. Well, there goes all my machine gun ammo. Oh my god, where do I go? You beat me from behind, you fucker. That was bullshit. I'm still fine though. I have no healing items though. Fuck. It's gotta be this way and up the stairs. Whoa! Liquor! Three grenades. Holy shit. See, I don't know what the goal is now. What do I do? What's the goal? Where am I headed? It doesn't even say. I guess the front door? So I gotta go through the watchman's room, through the east office, through here to the front door. Huh? What the fuck do I do? It's all blocked. Here, I guess. West office to keep running. Interesting attempt. It was an interesting attempt, right? Basically, it's a speed run. And you need to, first of all, that's impossible. There's no way Mr. X could have gotten up there because the floor was blocked. So basically, the game is cheating.
The end.